My philosophy is respect. Respect is very the key of my maybe what you arrive now. Always I respect my team. I respect the produce. This produce how you work. I respect about the tradition or about the food. This is the three key. As well I respect the guest. This one is very important. Respect the tradition. Yes, because it's the. I think the next 40-15 years we go to come back more in the tradition. Maybe it's more difficult to find the very traditional Italian restaurant, very traditional Chinese restaurant or Japanese restaurant. It's the, like the fine dining restaurant is go the like the traditional restaurant. The young chef, they try to do fusion, they try to do maybe fine dining, this one. But the guest, they want, if they order some Chinese restaurant, like a Peking duck or sucking pig, they want a traditional one. And the same if they go to Italian restaurant, they expect we have a pasta, risotto, or some traditional dish. Like I give you an example in Italy, like 20 years ago in the restaurant we have the mom, the cook, the whole family, the cook. This is why everybody go in Italy, they talk, oh, the food is great, the food now, they have the mom in the kitchen, the cook that. But now the new generation, they're not able to cook, you understand? And dunque we know, I don't know what is the next 20 years, how they go, the generation now, we need to teach how to do the traditional Chinese food, the traditional Japanese food. Always when you ask my chef to create a new dish, keep it traditional. Not try to do a fusion with the Chinese, with Japanese, or steakhouse, or with something else, but try to do traditional dish. You try to choose the best produce. You try to respect how they cook that. You try to serve a cleaner plate. You try to do the perfect dish of the traditional dish. This is what you ask my chef to do. In Italy, I work in one restaurant in Toscana. We call it Enoteca Finchior. It's a free Michelin star restaurant. They do one dish, is fresh pasta with olive oil. Okay, three Michelin star, fresh pasta with olive oil. Wow, it's, I know I tell you how much the price, okay? Wow, the people there, wow, three Michelin star. The first time I ate this pasta, fresh homemade pasta with the nice egg. The color of the pasta is very yellow, but it's very organic, farmer egg. The olive oil is the first press of olive oil is coming from the olive. See the quality of the flour. The flour is a crushed flour with the crush with the stone one. The quality so simple dish, but so nice that very impressed that I'm very surprised that they think it's so simple that is the they go to impress you how they do that. And after make pasta always when you go work in different country, sharing my passion about the pasta with the team, I enjoy that. First, they relax myself because when I teach the people how to make the ravioli, how to make the pasta, I want to teach the people my culture. I talk all the time with my team, and this is the art of the pasta. Understand? It's not think about only pasta. Okay, you cook spaghetti, this one, but the heart of the pasta. When you understand how to make the dough, how to touch the pasta, that you're able to make many things together. Understand? This is something. Very special. If you give it the passion to the people, the technique, right technique, after the people they do what they want. Understand? But first you need to share the passion to make something. Understand? I know everybody in the beginning when you finish the school, the first year, you do your job. I don't know, it's my job, I'm not sure, because you don't know exactly what is your job. Understand? After 10 years, I talk, this is my job, this is what you want to do. I know I want to change my job, and so I go to continue to develop. My first 20 years in my career, I work in Europe. After is, I feel I know everything of French, Italian, I feel that. But after when you arrive in Asia, I feel I don't know anything about Chinese cuisine, anything about Japanese cuisine, anything like that. I have so many things more to learn. I have so many things to learn. I never, sure, in one life you're not able to learn. You learn like 10% of what you have in the whole kitchen in the world, so maybe 0.1%. The job of chef is so big, so many choice can you able to do. I think so. I love my job. I recommend if you the people like a traveler, the people want a very hungry to learn, hungry for sharing that. It's a great job for you. That it's not easy. Like if you any job you do, if you want you go to push, if you want to do, you want to try to learn that. Any no one job is easy. You need to challenge yourself.